Dad, I feel so proud. I have studied the scriptures very well. I am an intelligent person.
My son, you sound so conceited. What makes you think you are so smart?
I am well read.
Son, I have a question for you. Can you tell me, by which knowledge one hears, what cannot be heard? By which knowledge one perceives, what cannot be perceived, and by which knowledge one knows, what cannot be known?
Dad, I am sorry. I do not know the answer. Please teach me.
My son, if you have a lump of clay, you can say what things are made of clay. The truth being, all is clay. If you have a nugget of gold, you will know that ornaments are made of it. Only the name and form are different. If you know this, the truth can also be known.
Tell me more.
Okay, my son, please bring me a fruit from this tree.
All right.
Now open the fruit, and tell me what you see inside.
I see tiny seeds.
Open a seed and tell me what is inside of it.
I do not see anything.
Son, what you cannot see in those tiny seeds is the essence. The big tree was born from it. Just as the unseen essence pervades the tree, in a similar way, that one true being pervades all existence. Have faith, my son.
I hear you, Dad.
Now, my son, please bring some salt, put it into a cup of water, and then stir it.
Okay, I will do that.
Now, can you take back the salt from the water?
I cannot find the salt anymore.
Now taste the water from different parts of the cup.
It's salty. It is the same everywhere.
My son, you do not see the salt, yet it is present everywhere in the water. In a similar way, that one true being pervades the entire universe.
Dad, I am so happy we had this conversation. I've learned so much from you. I even learned that I should be humble and respectful. This simplified conversation from the religious text the Upanishad was between the father Adilaka and his son Svetaketu. Well, this is J.R. Singh saying bye for now. If you would like to see more of my videos, please hit the subscribe button and click on the link in the description box.